this out. Hopefully the sound's gonna come out. Are we live? Can you guys hear me? I can hear myself, so hopefully this is working. Yes. Oof. Okay. I'm having some technical difficulties, gang. Minor technical difficulties. I've had this computer crash on me in the last month about 5 or 6 times. So I'm not sure what the deal is. I'm trying to write down the code for it whenever it's crashing, but it goes through too fast and I haven't had a pen and paper with me all the time. So I'll try to figure it out. And we're gonna keep on doing what we're doing. Assuming that I don't have any technical difficulties, and we'll see where it goes. Okay, but just in case, we're gonna have a little bit of technical difficulties popping up. Let me tell you what the next 2 live streams are going to be. Okay, and hopefully, you know, we won't have a kickstart. We won't have the computer crashing. But basically I got 2 lined up. By the way, thank you for being here. Sorry I haven't done live stream for a while. It's been, I think, 3 weeks or so since we did the last live stream. 3 or 4 weeks, but I was really busy with my students end of the year, prepping them for their finals and whatnot, right? But hopefully we're gonna kick things up in the next few days, get the ball rolling, and I'll get into my groove again, and we'll start catching up on our queue. I have a whole bunch of stuff that I need to get done, that I really want to get done. Okay, as far as announcements go, let me just make sure we're still streaming. Okay, it looks like we're streaming, but I don't see any text messages coming up or any chatter coming up. So let me open up a new thing. Hey, here you are, Ken. Hi, Chicho. Hello, Archus. How are you doing? Thank you for being here, guys. Cool. So it looks like it's working. X, welcome, welcome. Sorry I've been absent for a while. End of the year is usually pretty busy. End of the school year is usually pretty busy for me. Okay, but just in case my computer does a restart again, here are the next 2 live streams I got planned. Okay, the first one we're gonna do this Saturday, June 30th, 4 p.m. and it's a comic book haul video. Okay, and I have the, it's a small one. Okay, this is it. Okay, and this thing is Hicks break. Actually, it's I'm sort of coming out of a Bill Hicks break right now. It's for me, I do, the way I consider Bill Hicks breaks to be is I either take a break, just relax, chill, and take care of the mind and the body and whatnot, or on Bill Hicks breaks, I go hardcore learning something. And on this Bill Hicks break, good evening, good evening, Andre. On this Bill Hicks breaks that I announced, I guess, like February or something, my initial thing was I was going to take a little bit of break and get into live streaming slowly, but we just went hardcore into live streaming. So I sort of went ballistic with the Bill Hicks breaks, learning how to live stream, acquiring all this equipment and stuff, and doing a lot of things in the back end and Discord, Twitch, and all this jazz. So it's been a nice Bill Hicks breaks for me, just because I've acquired a lot of new tools, powers, right? But what I want to do now is basically sort of phase into our regular mode of programming, I guess you want to call it, and start doing the recording sessions. So what we're going to do on Saturday, we're going to live stream the comic book haul video, but I'm also going to record it with a lapel mic. So what we're going to do, we're going to basically, now that I have sort of a pretty good idea of how to go about this, what I want to do is categorize everything into sort of a behind-the-scenes playlist on YouTube. So we're gonna live stream things, and not all the live streams. We're gonna do a lot of just random live streams. Like right now, I'm not recording this on video and not shooting on lapel mic, but some of the main videos that we're gonna do, maybe be comic book videos, ASMR videos, some food-related stuff, the kitchen stuff where we're doing cooking. I think that's all just gonna be a live streaming. But basically, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna shoot the videos, recording with a lapel mic, edit the videos, upload them to YouTube, and then once and BitChute, of course. And once the edited videos have been loaded on, hello, Nath. Three. Once the videos have been loaded on to BitChute, YouTube, or whatever platform, and then I'm gonna upload the behind-the-scenes stuff. So basically, the way it's gonna work out on Saturday and every other video that we're gonna do, video just froze up on my end. Did it? Oh, let's see. Ah, still going on my end. Here, let me reduce this a little bit so I know that it's still recording or still live streaming. So basically, what I'm gonna do is we're gonna start the live stream, just have a little meet and greet, and then we're gonna do the recorded videos with the lapel mic as well as live streaming it, okay? And then after we finish recording it with the camcorder and the lapel mic, we're just gonna stop the recording, and then we're gonna go back to the live stream and talk about whatever you guys want to talk about, right? So we're sort of tag teaming this, okay? So on Saturday, June 30th, we're going to do a comic book haul video. And this video, comic book haul, is going to be linking up with the videos we've already done with investing in comics and ASMR math. Because I've, one reason is I got this comic book haul, this box, couple of days ago, but I've been searching for data regarding these comics that I bought, and it took me a little bit of time to find this data. One of the websites that had the print runs for the comics that we're going to take a look at, that was down, so I had to go to archive.org and look at the website on archive.org and just randomly start clicking on the pages that were saved from the website and see if I could find the page where it had the print runs for these comics, and I found it. So I put together some tables. We're going to look at a chart. I might try to get some other stuff ready for Saturday for us to take a look at. And this is definitely going to link up with ASMR math, investing in comic books, looking at charts and data and stuff like that. But we'll talk about that on Saturday. Okay. And then the next live stream that we're going to do is going to be Tuesday, July 3rd. At 2 p.m. okay, and it's going to be an update video, and it's going to be an open discussion for sure, and it's going to be an update video. And for me, just in case, I don't think I've shared this before, but for me, these update videos, oops, these update videos are some of the hardest videos for me to do, because I sort of have to, get organized, take a look at my queue, my to-do list, take a look at what I've already done, try to plan ahead for the future. So consider these update videos sort of to be like a company doing their quarterly or year-end touching base with their shareholders and stuff like this. So consider this to be sort of a shareholder meeting. So what we're gonna do, again, we're gonna do the same routine. We're gonna start the live stream, do sort of a meet and greet, salutations and whatnot, and then record it on a camcorder lapel mic. And I'm gonna talk about some of the things that I wanna talk about. And then we're gonna come back to the live stream, and if there's any questions, we can answer those questions. And just so you know, for the update video, okay, I'm going to talk a little bit about the technical difficulties I've been having. Okay, just touch on that. We're going to talk a little bit about the behind the scenes, what we plan on doing with recording videos and live streaming. Okay, we're going to talk about the end of prohibition, just very little. Okay, it's going to be a quick live stream. First live stream. You caught a good one. We're about to kick things up to the next phase on this. That. It should be fun. We'll see how it goes. As long as this little computer, my baby holds out. The technical difficulties have been a little jarring from my end, going, oh no, right? If I had to do it over again, this laptop I bought cost me about 2 grand. If I had to do it over again, I would double it. I would buy a laptop that was about 4 grand just to kick things up, so the humming would disappear and I wouldn't have these little hello Spamalot, how are you doing? Technical difficulties that have shown up in less than a year, right? We're gonna talk about in the update a little bit about comic books. We're gonna talk about some of the mathematics that we possibly, I ran it past the mods on Discord. We might create a folder where people can share data or topics that they want us to talk about in ASMR math, and we can basically take the data and create ASMR math videos on it, but more on that in the update. And we'll talk a little bit about some of the other videos we have planned out and what we're going to do. Okay. As for the update video that we're about to do on Tuesday, if there's anything you guys want to cover, if you want me to touch on, to talk about, to let you know what we're doing, let me know and I'll take some notes on it and I'll bring that up during the update and the open discussion on Tuesday, right? So again, consider the Tuesday live stream session a sort of a shareholder meeting session, sort of a quarterly update, yearly update, as if a company was telling their shareholders what they were doing, and at the end of doing a yearly update or a quarterly update for a company or an institution, usually there's a Q&A session at the end, and we'll definitely do that on Tuesday as well. Okay. I did my CSA final exam. I got my results in. I get. Oh, you get your results in August. Nice. But I remember. I thought you said you did well on that Spamalot. I hope you did well on that. Okay. The GCSE. GCSE. I'm assuming that's the equivalency for UK, I believe. Okay. Or it could be the entrance exam to go into the next phase. I can't remember. It's been a while since you mentioned that. But that's about it. That's the two live streams we have planned. And there's a whole bunch of videos I got lined up for us to do this summer. And there's going to be ASMR math, there's going to be comic books, there's going to be stuff related to Mermaid Publications, what we're going to do. I'm going to go through some boxes hopefully by Tuesday and maybe show you guys some stuff. We'll see how it goes, but no rush. We'll get things done in a timely manner, and sometimes we'll go ballistic and get a lot done. Sometimes we'll do a little pause while I get organized, and there might be a little bit of downtime between the live streams because I will be editing videos as well between the live stream sessions, because I do want to have the edited videos being loaded up with the lapel mic. A little bit less chill with the sound quality, not having the humming sound from the computer. I did well on the coursework, thanks to you. I got an A. Ah, that's right, you got an A. I remember you mentioned that, Spamalot. I did my exam last week, and my overall grade is a combination of the two results. Okay, perfect. So you're in. If you get an A in coursework, and I'm assuming it's not 50-50. Hopefully, it's not 50% the exam and 50% coursework. But if you got an A in the coursework, then you should be set. That should sort of, you're at least above 70. Hopefully, anyway. Hopefully, anyway. Okay. Oof. The computer didn't crash during this live stream, so I gotta take a look at this stuff. I gotta look in the background of this. Okay. No, it's 25% coursework and 75% exam, 25% coursework. Oof, oof, oof. Okay, fingers crossed, brother. Hopefully, it went well. That's putting a lot of weight on the exam. If you have a bad day, it might seriously affect you, but we see, we see. I know during my university days, I've had times where my exams were worth 100% of my mark. That was either because the coursework was really heavy and you just didn't have time to prepare for the exams and the homeworks and stuff, or I just slacked off and I just made the exams worth 100%, which I had to do a few times, which I had to do. I had to do serious learning before the exams, the final exams. It was fun going with that mindset. Serious studying sessions, right? Okay. Oh, by the way, I've already set up the event pages on Twitch. Okay, so they should, if you're subscribed, hopefully it'll send a notice saying that it has gone live, and I will definitely post it on Twitter as well when I'm going live. And there's a little doohickey on Twitch as well where it does a little countdown. What is this thing called? Streamlabs stream schedule countdown. So I've put him in there as well. So there's a countdown going on Twitch, letting you guys when the next live stream is going to be coming up. I slipped up on an explanatory variable and response variable in the exam, but other than that, I went, well, okay, good. Some of those questions they give you guys during those exams are, they're wordplay. They try to trip you up. I don't like it. And you know how I feel about our education system. I have a few things to say regarding that, but we'll leave that alone. We won't talk about it during the during the update video, but I will definitely address some of the issues regarding our education system in the future. There's some changes that have come along in my part of the world. Again, one of the ones, let me just read this comment. We were never even taught it. You were never even taught it during the exam. Crazy. I can't believe they do that. I can't. The education is horrendous. Reading any new comic book titles? I am. I'm actually reading, not titles. Actually, two comic books I just put on my pull list. I grabbed them yesterday and I added them. I went to the comic shop store today and I added them. One of them is Teen Titans, because it's Lobo's daughter, and if you've been following my comic book work, I love Lobo. So I grabbed the Teen Titans special yesterday, number one, with the little cameo of Lobo's daughter, one panel. And I guess the first full appearance is going to be Teen Titans. And I added Venom as well, with the Venom, the symbiote god. But one other book I'm reading is a trade paperback that came out regarding Epic of Gilgamesh, and it's the first comic book adaptation of Epic of Gilgamesh. I'm just at the beginning parts. I like it. I've read Epic of Gilgamesh. I've had it read to me, but I like the comic book format. Once I finish reading this, I'm gonna do a review on it. Where on Twitch do I see the countdown? If you, Andre, if you scroll down on the Twitch page, it's right down. Right below the video streaming. It's right now, it says 2 days and 2 hours. All you have to do is just scroll down the main page of Twitch and you'll see the countdown kicking in. Okay. Da, 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 da. I picked up Captain America 100 to 126. Wow. That must have been a cost you a pretty penny. 100 to 126, that's expensive. Great haul though. Wow, if you got that. Right now I'm really like, oh, Walk Through Hell. I picked up the first issue, and the second issue came out last week, I believe, and I picked that up as well. It's not on my pull list. If I don't read it within 3 issues, I usually don't add them to my pull list, but I did pick it up, most definitely. Man, oh, I see. To read that, I'm fascinated by it. Yeah, this the. The trade paperback of Epic of Gilgamesh, I read the intro to it. There's three people that have worked on it. One of them is, or is it two people? No, there's someone doing an intro to it, I believe, and then the person that wrote it, and then the artist. The people who put it together are a father and son team that put it together. And if you're gonna pick it up, maybe I'll show it to you guys on the comic book haul if I remember. But I will definitely do a review of that, of the trade paperback once I finish reading it. That's going to be my summer reading at the beach or at the park. Oh, only 300 pounds for Captain America 100 to 126? That's a great deal. I can't remember. I picked up some other things as well. That's a great deal. 300 pounds, that comes out to, I think that's about 500 bucks Canadian or so, depending on the grade, but that's a great haul. Those are key issues, basically. The return of Captain America. Nice haul, nice haul. I picked up, I'm very happy with this haul that I got. And with this haul that we're gonna do on Saturday, trying to find the data for these comic books, the print runs for them, because I was ready to do the live stream and to do the comic book haul. I thought it was a steal, definitely a steal. Captain America 100 to 126 for 300 pounds. Great price, great price. But for these comic book haul that we're gonna do on Saturday, I couldn't find a website that had the print run, so I went to a couple of forums and I was asking people, where is this page? Where is this page? And a couple of days later, searching around a couple of hours a day, 2 or 3 hours a day, trying to find this data, I finally found it. And when I posted one of the posts that I did in the forum, one of the people that commented said, "Hey, I think you're the guy that bought these comics." So the person was like, "Hey, those are the comics that I just sold on eBay and you bought them." So I thought it was pretty cool. And I told him what I'm gonna do with it, and he was pretty excited about it. And they're all Valiants, by the way. They're all Valiants. Check out Death of Glory. Death of Glory is Remender, right? I picked up the first issue. There's two issues out. I think Death or Glory is Rick Remender, and I'm picking up basically almost everything, or I sample it anyway, that Rick Remender puts out. You have tremendous willpower. I'd break that box. Dude, it's been hard, and I have to keep it like this for a couple of days, because usually when I get the comic book hauls, I try to crack open the boxes right away just to make sure the comics are sitting nice. But I've kept it like this for 2 days. I'll keep it like this for 2 days. I put it this way, so I think they're going to be sitting nicely. Hopefully, they're not getting damaged. I have my fingers crossed. I have trust in the guy that sold it, that I'm assuming he packaged it well. I hope. He seemed like a nice guy once, which exchanged a couple of comments. Just had a look at my valuable short box. I got. Nice, number 228-30. Sweet. That's good. Man, back in the day, I had the opportunity to pick up Captain America 100, a nice Captain America run 100 to, I don't know where it was. And I just didn't. I was picking up other things and I had to manage my funds. And I wasn't into Captain America at the time. This was, I guess, late 1990s. I was into some other comic books. So instead of picking up Captain America, I picked up Amazing Spider-Man, a whole bunch of issues, like 50 issues that are below 100. So that was what I ended up doing. It was a good buy that I did, but I wish I had enough funds to pick up the Captain Americas as well. There's some amazing comic books being put out, gang. Like, the comic books being put out right now are fantastic. Just one comic re comment regarding the comic book haul, that one here that we're gonna do. What I've been doing is searching on eBay, and good buys are getting harder and harder to find. And because of eBay's global shipping program, I'm basically shut out of the US market now, because eBay's global, for some reason, American sellers, majority of them I've come across, they're using eBay shipping, global shipping program. So basically, I'm almost buying everything from Canadian sellers now. It's bloody 30 degrees here in the UK. I'm off to get a cold shower. Sweet. Have a nice shower, man. Cool down. Over here, it's warm, cool. It's still cool here. I'm back. Sorry, Mr. No worries, Valiance. No worries. Oh, Valiance, you're going to love this haul. The next, this haul that we're going to do is a Valiant Hall, and I have another hall coming as well. Okay, so there's gonna be this is the Saturday one, is our first comic book haul, and then we're gonna do another comic book haul when I get the rest of the comics, and I'm excited about that one as well. Very excited about this one as well. Yes, it's Rick. Nice, Rick Remender. Yeah, Rick Remender's writing is, I think he's one of the best writers out there. With Lemire is fantastic. There's a few amazing, like seriously, you can, there's so many comics I wish I had the time to read. I'm just picking up a lot of comics just to have so I can read later, just to have in my box, in my collection, because some of the stuff is, you know, in the aftermarket, they're being sold for premium prices, and I don't want to pay premium prices, so I'm maxing out my funds for comic books, getting comics that I might not be reading right now, just putting them away so I don't have to pay premium price later on, because the print runs on some of the stuff, the print runs are slowly picking up. They have been, I believe, in the last year or so. There's an influx, I think, of people buying comic books, and the good deals on eBay, they're disappearing. Really, that's what I'm finding. The searches that I'm doing, there's a lot of. I'll let you guys know about the comic book haul stuff later. But basically, a lot of the sellers that I used to buy from, in the last couple of days or last 4 days, I've gone through the saved sellers that I've had on eBay, and half of them are not selling anymore. They're done. Another quarter, they no longer are selling lots at auction. They all, you know, most of their books are buy it now. So inventory is running low on a lot of sellers that I've been following for a number of years, right? They're done. Like, they don't have any more books to sell, or they're waiting to buy collections from people to relist them. Okay. Plenty of my name in the next haul. Looking for. Oh, you're gonna love this. I was so happy with this. This little baby here. This guy right here. Okay. I might crack it open just to make sure the comics are sitting nicely. Will you guys forgive me if I do this? I need to do this, I think. I just want to make sure they're sitting well. Should we do it? No, I'm going to keep it like this. We've kept it like this for a couple of days. We'll keep it like this for a couple more days. Okay. There won't be any damage done. I have faith, trust. And by the way, Valiants, this haul you're going to enjoy, and the next haul that is going to be coming also has Valiants in there. And you'll love that one as well. Okay, I paid a little bit, I paid full price for the next haul coming in, just because I didn't want it to get away, and there was, I'll read you the comment, but I'll give you a little heads up. After I made this purchase, the comic haul that we're going to do Saturday, this one, I had, maybe crack it open, see what the top, you want to know, fun. Just so you know, after I did this haul, this comic book haul, right, I got into editing the cryptocurrency video. So I was doing a lot of editing and stuff like this. I was taking a break, and usually when I take a break, I just go online and just chill with something, right? And usually I check my emails first. So I checked my emails, and there was a message from someone saying that, just saying thank you, Chicho, you know, they've been following my work for a number of years, and they really appreciated what I was doing, especially the comic book stuff. And they said, by the way, they wanted to send me, you know, contribute a little bit, support my work a little bit, and they wanted to make a little donation. And the only stipulation they had was that I had to use that money to buy comic books, right? And I'm like, okay, done deal. 100%, right? I said it's a great stipulation, and I love doing comic buys, and I love doing these comic book haul videos, right? So I said, yeah, for sure. And I had a little bit of money left over after doing this buy, right? So I thought, okay, I'll have a little bit of money, and there's a few things that I was eyeing to get, right, that I didn't have the funds for. So this is what I could afford that we're gonna do on Saturday. And then the guy sent the money, right, through PayPal, and it was more than I was hoping for, right? So as soon as he sent it to me, I sent him a message saying, "Oh my God, thank you very much. I can go and make offers, buy some of the things that I was trying to get, right, that I didn't have enough funds for." So the second comic book haul video is in huge part thanks to the person who contributed some funds to the comic book hauls. And I'll read his comment once we do that haul, and probably I'll read it once we do this one as well. Chicho, check out Hypno Comics on eBay. Hypno Comics, it's my local comics shop. They have weekly auctions starting at 99 cents. Wait a second, are they doing no, Zara, you're in the States. I know. Hey Zara, by the way, what you will call it, there's a comic book store that's in Alberta that I found because I've been doing mainly searching for Canadian sellers, and that's what they're doing too. They have a lot of buy it nows, but then to get traffic to their page, they do 99 cent auctions. But I'll check this out. Hypno Comics on eBay. Cool. I'm gonna grab this. Open it up in a tab. That way I can remember as soon as we finish the live stream, I'll go check them out. I'm tapped out right now with the next haul coming in. This one and the next haul sort of tap me out, so I have to wait until I get more funds in my account to be able to do another haul. But I'll definitely check them out and track them and see what they're putting up. And again, if you're in the States, man, I don't know why so many sellers from the US are using eBay's global shipping program. There's one, by the way. Are you guys into doing some bids? Let me find you something. Let me find you something. Okay, let me do this. I'm gonna send you a link. Okay. And I messaged this person and I asked them if they would if they would check out this link. Now I don't know this person. They're not. Hopefully that sends you, it should send you to the right place. Okay. If you guys are into it, I messaged this person and I asked them, just quickie, is X-Force any good? I bought issue one, two. I liked X-Force. I liked some of it. Is it worth reading them? Whew, is it worth reading them? There's way better comic books out there right now than what X-Force. I'm assuming you're saying X-Force from the 1990s, right? X-Force from the 1990s. It had a lot of drama. It had its fun moments. But I read a few issues and then I dropped it. X, yeah, 1 to 80, I mean. Yeah, that's the whole run, I'm assuming, as in 80 comics. Yeah, issue number 1 to 80. I think it finished number 80 or something. It was okay. You could flip through it. They're fun reads. I don't know. I didn't read past the teens. I got into the teens and I didn't continue on from there. But some people like some of the stuff that was coming out later on. I haven't read anything past the teens and X-Force. I don't believe so anyway. I would have to take a look at the covers if I remember. Sometimes I don't remember. Yeah, for sure. Layfield at Deadpool was 98, New Mutants 98. And then I believe the second appearance of Deadpool was X-Force number 2, and they had the card in the polybag with the, they put out five versions of X-Force number 1 with polybags, I think five versions, and one of them had the Deadpool card in there. And then Domino's first appearance is an issue number, the real appearance, I think there's like three appearances. The first one is nine New Mutants 98, but that was supposed to be a fake one, and There's another fake one in early X-Force, and then the real one is in number 7 or 8 or something like this. I forget what it is. They were fun. They're very 1990s comic book. Really, that's all. Yes, I got issue 5 with a Deadpool card in it, unopened plastic. Yeah, I wouldn't open that one. You could probably find X-Force number 1 in a dollar bin. If you know, dollar paying for X-Force number 1, even in a poly bag, a dollar is probably the maximum price you want to pay. You could probably get it at a better price. Hopefully, anyway, I don't know how much they're going for right now. I haven't checked them, but they're very common. There's tons of them printed, tons of them printed. Okay. I don't want to open it though. Don't open it. Don't open it. Seriously. Just go through your dollar bins at your comic book store, and there might be an X-Force number 1 in there. Okay. And just get that for 50 cents, 25 cents, 75 cents, dollar. I wouldn't pay more than a dollar for it. Okay. Opened or unopened, doesn't make a difference. As far as I know, last time I checked, which was many, many, many moons ago. Many moons ago. Okay. So, where was I going? Oh, yeah. If you guys are into the first appearance of the Max, a comic book reading that we did, this person, the link that I sent you, is doing an estate sale, and they have 20 primer number 5s up for sale, and there's 20 hours left. Okay, they're not in great condition. They're scuffed up the edges, so they weren't stored properly or whatnot. But personally, I emailed the guy asking him if he would ship to Canada, and he wouldn't. Okay, and personally, for me, right now the thing's listed at $140 US. 20. Personally, I would pay at least 200 US for that. Okay, just to let you know, I'm not going to be bidding on it because I can't get that shipped out to Canada. The guy said he would ship it to someone in the US if I gave him an address, but I'm not into doing double shipping and stuff like this. Okay. I also have issue 1 collector's edition with the card in it, also still in plastic bag. If you have one without the Deadpool card, that you could probably open. Okay. I don't think the value on it is going to change much. Okay. If you want to read it, but what I would do if I was you, I would probably grab issue number 2. I think issue number 2 is a Deadpool appearance. Grab issue number 2, read that one. If you like it, and if you want to continue reading, then you can crack open issue number 1 and read that. Yeah, it's the Deadpool card. Oh, yeah, don't open the Deadpool card one because, you know, it's a Deadpool card one. It will be worth more than, I don't know what it's going for, to tell you the truth right now. But it's worth more than the other ones. Okay. And by the way, X-Force, their first appearance was in New Mutants 100. Okay. And New Mutants 100 was the last issue of New Mutants. Okay. And then they kicked it off into X-Force. But I would say read a couple of issues of X-Force. If you decide to crack open the plastic bag with the Deadpool card, then you can. You're not losing too much value. There are some people that want to collect it, but see how it goes. You could probably find it online as well, somewhere. Right? There are many places that you can, if you have comic books that you don't want to damage, as far as I'm concerned, you should be able to read those online for free because you bought the hard copy. Okay, that's just my 2 cents worth of commentary regarding you know, the one-eyed pirates, I guess. Right. Cool. Okay, gang. This was our unannounced live stream. Okay. I don't know if how did a command go? Uptime? Uptime. Is that gonna work? Oh, cool. Nightbot is still active. That's good. So Nightbot says we've been live for 39 minutes. That's the longest unannounced stream we've done, I think. So gang, I think that's about it. I'll see you guys Saturday for the comic book haul video if you can make it. And or Tuesday, July 3rd at 2 p.m. Okay, for an update video. Okay, we'll do, Valiant. See you guys soon. Oh my God. What's up, Spamalot? What did you find? How much is it going for? Is that what you checked? I gotta find out what the Oh My God is from. Issue 100, Captain is on eBay for. Yeah. Holy, yeah. You got issue number 100 to 128, I think. You got a great deal for £400. Later, Shisho. Later, Zara. Okay, gang. I'll see you guys Saturday or Tuesday or maybe an unannounced live stream between those times to give you let you guys know what the next live streams are, and there'll be videos being loaded on YouTube. We're basically into full active mode again. Okay, Bill Hicks break done. I'll see you guys Saturday.